Hey, what's going on, my friends? It is Vasterz, aka G-Saves. And just making this little announcement. The server's not finished just yet, but there are some changes that you should be aware about. And also, just gonna give you guys a little guide and stuff like that on things you can do on the server right now. Well, not right now, but when the server comes out, you won't be lost, I guess you would say. You'll like know where to go and stuff like that. So the server IP, guys, is actually called play.thelightinus.com. And the reason why we actually changed it from thelightinus.com to this is simply because it fixes a lot of issues. We do have other like subdomains, and I believe you can still use the regular domain like thelightinus.com, but it has some issues, and it's better if you use this one. This was one of the strongest ones that we have. It seems to be working for every staff member, and yeah, I recommend you guys use this one right here. So yeah, let's get started, guys. Let's go on the server, just check it out. So I'm gonna take you guys around and show you guys things you can do and stuff like that. So this is actually the lobby area, which could use a lot of improvements, simply because, I mean, come on, look at the building. Like, this looks so plain. I kind of just want to like just take one day off and just build like a whole new like lobby area. But you know, you gotta remember, this is exactly like how we started, pretty much. I know that this thing could be completely transformed to something insane, like a billion times better than it is right now, in the design. So yeah, if we get bungee cord, guys, this thing is gonna look insane. But right here, guys, this is actually the lobby. You spawn here, and then you go to this guy. This is the game selection screen. So you can pick OP Prison, or you can pick Kit PvP for right now. You can also go to Trails and also Pets. Trails, you can pretty much almost use them like all over like the whole entire server. As for Pets, you can only use them in the hub and the lobby areas. Social media, so just if you want to click it, it tells you like the YouTube and stuff like that. And then the rules. Pretty simple. Around the server, we have that. You can use that instead to go to different worlds, such as the Kit PvP or the Prison World. It tells you if you get a little bit close. I'm a little bit far right now, but let me get a little bit closer. There you go. And it shows up. There you go. So yeah, let's go to like Kit PvP. So in the hub, you can't really do much. Like right now, you can't really do too much. It's just you log in and then you select the game mode. So let's go to like the Kit PvP game mode, and here we go. You're gonna spawn right here, and this looks a lot better than it did before. I'll let you guys know that. But right here, you can actually select a kit. So if you want this or this, it's all this right here for Kit PvP. It's free, so you don't have to actually pay in-game stuff. Maybe in the future, we might make it so you have to unlock classes and stuff like that. But for right now, this is pretty much just a PvP, you know, like a brawl, I guess you'd say. It's a whole entire how would you say that, like an arena completely, you know. You just go in there and just own it up. So yeah, you can just select different kits, and some kits have like certain like boosts. When you defeat somebody in Kit PvP, they will drop their gear and you can pick it up and switch the outfit, and you just click on this sign, random TP, and it will take you to a random location on the map. It's pretty cool. That's pretty cool, but that's pretty much about it for like Kit PvP. That's all it is. You select a class and you go and you PvP. Very, very simple to do. Very, very easy. We're still working on designs, so just be aware of that. But this right here looks insane. I mean, look at that. Look at this thing. That looks awesome. It looks insane. Glorifying actually made that right there. I don't know if he had any help, but that's insane. But let's go to like back to the hub. Get used to this, guys, because I know this commands that lets you go to different like worlds, stuff like that. I recommend you guys get used to just going back to the hub and then going over here and selecting the game, because if you get bungee cord, that's how it's gonna be. So just get used to doing that, going back to the lobby and switching game modes. So you talk to this guy again, or if you want to go through the little, you know, portal thingy, a teleportation device, you can do that as well. So let's go over there. And here we are. Here we are, my friends. The OP prison. And this is what it looks like for right now. And pretty much on the OP prison, there's different things you can do. And this is going to be a little bit, you know, there's commands and stuff like that that I want you guys to be aware of. And just so you guys know. So, yeah. Okay, so over here you have staff information. Over here you have a relaxing area. It's pretty much a little bit of parkour. I might change it a little bit because it's pretty plain right now. Right here is a help sensor, so if you have questions, you can just walk all the way over there. This is right here is actually the actual prison mine. So you just go through here, and you know, you'll be rank A. Like, for example, if I type in Chaz, you can see I'm rank A. You can do slash kits. Ignore a bunch of those kits. You can only do, like, I think it's 3 of them or 4 of them for right now. And the other ones are simply just for, like, admins and stuff like that to see if it works. With the command. Right here you have the little repair sign. If you have to repair any items, you can repair it. As you can see, you walk over here. This is just a mine. You know, if you play prison game mode, you know, I'm not really gonna get into that, but that's pretty much what it is. You sell stuff there. There's also a little donation thing if you want to go in there and maybe you want to put an item in there and someone else can open it and get the item. That'd be pretty cool. So yeah, that's pretty awesome. But yeah, it's pretty much the prison game mode. But commands that you guys can do that I recommend you guys are aware of and remember is slash trade and then the player's name. This will actually send a trade request to the other person, and you can actually trade with the other person. So if you got like an item, let's say like a diamond sword or something like that, and you want to trade it and not risk the chance of getting scammed or something like that, just do slash trade. And also, if anybody scams you or something like that, you know, send some video evidence and stuff like that, because that's not cool at all. So yeah, that's pretty messed up. We have rules, so yeah. But yes, that's one command that's really, really important, since is the slash trade command. It is very, very simple to do. It gives you this GUI and shows you what's going on, which items, how much the person wants to give you for money and stuff like that. Other things you can do is I'm thinking of things like that are not like basic, because you have like I'm pretty sure you can actually give money to other players if you do like the what's it called, like the give command or something like that, or the pay command, I think that's what it is. Yeah, it is. It's the pay command. I think you guys should be able to do that. If there's any errors or anything like that when the server releases, just, you know, let the staff know, let me know, and we'll fix it up. But yeah, you can actually pay other players. If you don't want to do the little GUI thing with a trade, you can simply just pay the person, and then they can just drop the item. It's a little bit more risky, but you can actually get a much more accurate price on the one you want, because a trade GUI isn't that advanced compared to just paying somebody, you know, with like, you know, maybe you want to put like 0.1 or something, I don't even know. Maybe like $1 or something like that. You can't really... It's a limit, if you guys get what I mean. That's pretty much what I'm trying to get to. There's a limit with the trade command. So that's one of them right there, guys, that I recommend you guys remember. Something else that you guys should remember is also you can do slash plot me, and it will give you a list of commands that you can do, and then you can do like plot me, then a different page, and it will tell you other information. Depending on your rank and stuff like that, it will show different things on this list. Since I'm actually in the owner group and stuff like that, I get a lot of commands and all that stuff. But pretty much, if you guys don't know what plots are, it's pretty much you can make your own little house, and you can make a nice little like a player shop that if you want to sell items, you can do it from there as well. So there's many ways, guys, you can trade items to other players. The chest shop is what the plugin is that we use for plot me, and it is very, very advanced, and it's one that I'm actually very familiar with, and I recommend if you guys are going to sell an item, sell it on there. And I'm going to show you guys how exactly you can do that very, very simply. So, one, you want to make sure you have a plot me area. And there's a command, I think it's like plot me, there it is, plot me auto, I think, that's what it is. It should, like, right there, as you can see, plot me auto, it gave me a little area, and then I can do it again, I believe, as you can see, there we go. And then if I do plot H, it will take me over here. The question is, we go to creative. So there's my old one, my first one. Here's the second one, and that's the other one. So if I do plot H, I believe it's 2 like that, it will take me to a different one, and if I do number 3, it will take me to this one right here. So you can have a different, you know, plots and all that stuff. It's pretty basic. Just do the plot me command. It tells you some information on there. You know, if you got it clear or anything like that, you can figure that out. So let me go over here and reset that one as well. So there we go. That one's ready to go. So that's pretty much one thing. You can make a nice little house, because you got to make your house if you want to make a player shop over here, pretty much. Unless if you use someone else's area. But that's a little bit risky, you know, if you're added to somebody else's like plot. Like right now for this my friend right here, I can actually break stuff if I wanted to and stuff like that. But if it was for like someone that didn't add me, I wouldn't be able to. But since I'm off, I could do that. But pretty much there's, for some reason, this glowstone here. Let me just slash clear. There we go. So pretty much things that you can do, guys, like I was talking about, is actually the little shops. And I'm gonna go like over here somewhere, and I'm gonna put 3 chests. I'm gonna get a sign as well, and I'm gonna show you guys how this stuff works, if I remember. Hopefully I remember this. First line is your name, second line is a quantity. So if I want to put like 7, like, you know, stuff, and then you want to put the buy or sell price. The buy price, what you do is you click the letter B and then the amount you want to actually buy it for. So I'm gonna put this for like 1820. And then for the last one is the item you want to sell. So if I go with like, I don't know, let's go with like, let's go with diamonds. Actually, no, let's go with emeralds. We owned diamonds before. If you do that, that's actually a pretty cool example. So if you mess up on the item ID, simply go over here and check the item. As you can see, I put an S at the end of emerald. So simply just get the item you want to sell and do slash item info. It will tell you the item ID. So instead, right now, we're going to be putting the item ID. So that's pretty cool that actually happened right there. So let's make it 7, buy price 1820, and then 3 AA is what we're going to go for, because that's the number that showed up. Once you do this, it's going to make the little shop, and you don't have to like put the little item info code thing if you don't want to. So like, for example, it will still work, as you can see, and how the players will be able to use the shop. And then over here, that's the buy one. So if someone else shows up and they're like, I kind of want to buy some emeralds right now, and they can buy it. They can buy emeralds from your thing. It will subtract emeralds, and they'll be able to get the emeralds, and you'll get, you know, some money in return. Other things you can do is actually the sell command. I'm gonna do the same thing, but this time I'm probably gonna do with like maybe what's a cool little item we can put. Put like the gold block, I guess. So let's get the gold block. Once again, like if you look at the name of this one, it's called block of gold. If you put that, it's probably not even gonna fit. I'm not even sure. But pretty much simply, like I said, just do item info. It will tell you the item ID, and just do what we were doing before. This one, I'm actually gonna be putting the buy and sell for this one right here. So the buy, I'm gonna put like 116. I'm gonna put this, and then for the sell, I'm gonna put 1820. And then I'm gonna put, I believe it's 41. And wait, let me see. 41, yes. Okay, let me see if I can remember this. Quantities, make it like 7. Let's make it 3. The buy price. How do I. There we go. Oh, I get it, guys. I just realized why it's doing that. I actually put something in the comment, because I was wondering, why is it destroying the shop? The reason why, guys, I might disable that, but I'm not too sure, is because some people can actually scam you real bad on this if you don't look at the prices for buy and sell. If someone actually tries to, like, if you buy something, let's say an item or something like that. For right now, I might change it when the server releases and stuff like that. But let me show you guys. I'll put 3, I'll put buy, and I put, for the buy price, I put 116, and for the sell price, I put 1820. The thing about that is, like, this is not allowed for right now. I might change it because it might get annoying. But the reason why it's not allowed is because if you buy the items for this much, and then by accident you sell it, the other person, you know, the one that made the chest, or the, you know, the shop, you know, whoever that player is will actually get, you know, money in return, and you're gonna, you know, be ripped off and stuff like that. So that's just a way to prevent some scamming going on and some trickery going on, because that could happen. I might remove that, you know, get you guys first. Maybe I'll let it go, you know, at the start, you know, server release. Maybe I just let it be there for a little bit. After people get the hang of it, I could probably change it. But yeah, that's probably why I was doing that. Like, watch, if I do 1820 and then I put the cell 116, that's different now. So now you're gonna have to pay 1820 for the item that's over here, and you can sell it only for 116. So that's more like balance, you know, it's not a risk. Then right here you put like the item ID or the name, and that will work, as you can see. So remember that. Another one you can do is just the regular sell price. So if I do sell, let's say I want to sell it for 1820, and then let's say, I don't know, diamond. There you go. And there you go, you have a nice little shop right there. And you wouldn't have to be able to place these down here. You're going to have to place them down in your little house. You can actually sell stuff there and so on and so forth in your house. And then if you want to put in the chat something like selling, I don't know, like emeralds and other loot in plot world. do/plot h, and then the name goes here. So whoever, you know, if your name is like, you know, Gabriel, you can put Gabriel on there, you know, on your character name. So that's how it works. And then, you know, like, let's say this is how it's gonna look like for me. You do this, and this message will be sent also to the prison world, if, you know, it works correctly and stuff like that, and also the world you're currently in, you know. So it's gonna go to the OP prison and also the plot me, which is pretty cool. So it's kind of like a game mode thing. It sends it out there so people are aware of this, and you can start selling stuff. There are things that people do with the shops as well, which is called OP shops, and there's a loud car or whatever that is outside. But some players, what they do in different servers is they make an OP shop. They put a really nice value item, so it seems, but it's a win-win for both situations. Which this is allowed on our server, but I'm also going to tell you guys one thing that's not allowed on the server that could get you banned or reset. So I don't do this right here. I'm going to show you guys what not to do. So let's go to Warp A. This is the first mine, right? So let's say if you're starting a mine and then this guy out of nowhere is like, let's say he's max rank, you know, like rank Z on the server, right? And he's like, hey, you want to go for, you know, mine Z? You want to go over there? You know, I can TP you over there. Not even admins are allowed to do this. Let me just tell you guys that. This completely breaks the whole game. It breaks the fun of it. It's not right, guys. So let's say if the person's like teleports to Warp Z, and the person sends an invite to teleport the other person that just started the game to a mine that he's not supposed to be at, and he starts using and selling stuff. That right there will make it horrible, because the thing about it is the person that's Z rank and also the other person that abused it, both could get reset, and or, you know, maybe muted, you know, for, you know, luring somebody to break the rules or something like that, because that's really messed up. It breaks the concept of the game. Do not do that. That's very messed up. I'm not even allowed to do that, because it's not right. You have to be your appropriate rank to be in the appropriate mind. You know, you can't, you know, be like a, you know, like, let's say like your rank C, and all of a sudden you go to like TP to rank Y from like a friend you have. Don't do that, because that will reset both of you more than likely. You know, that's something that just breaks the whole concept of the game, and yeah, don't do that, guys. Just letting you guys know ahead of time, don't do that. But something that players do, let's go to like Warp E. What I was talking about before is OP shops, which is pretty cool. And it's like a win-win situation for both people. So as you can see right here, we have some nice little blocks and stuff like that. You look over here for the prices, and you'll see these are actually a little bit better than, let's say, like Warp A or something like that. As you can see, they're a little bit better. So if you actually end up like going to, you know, your plot world, right? Let's say I get like I don't know, you know, give Vasterz iron ingot. So let's say I got this iron ingot from this mine right here, from Warp E. If you do the math over here, and you go over here, and you can sell this for that much, right? That's pretty cool, you can sell it for that much, as you can see. And you got the mines from this, and then you decide, you know what, I kind of want to sell this item, these resources that I'm getting on this mine, on the little house that I have. So you do, you know, same exact thing, you go to your little plot world, and you sell this, but you can actually increase the value item to your appropriate mine, you know, so it's not like messed up and stuff like that. But you do that, it's a win-win, simply because more players are gonna go to your, you know, your plot world to sell stuff because they can get more money. So if a rank A goes to your little plot world, or you know, the little map section thing, that's what I'm talking about, and he sees your shop and it's really, really nice compared to the prices of his mine that the person's in, and he's like, I kind of want to sell on this instead of selling on the mine, and this will actually help the person to rank up that's lower rank. And it will also, you know, get the person that actually has that OP shop, pretty much, it gets the name out there, I guess you would say. Pretty much it's like, yeah, this person, you know, he sells, you know, very nice valued items, you know, and stuff like that. So it's a pretty much win-win situation for that. And yeah, it's pretty awesome, guys. So yeah, you don't have to put, like, let's say if I wanted to sell this and the item for my mind, let's say Warp E was like, I think was it 60k or something like that for a full stack, I think. I already forgot. But let's say if it was 60k, right? And I'm just like, okay, you know what, I wanna help other players out. I'm gonna put this for 57k. If I put it for 57k and someone sells it, they'll be getting every single time they sell, or they buy or sell, whatever, which one you're doing. For the item, you know, it's 57k you put for the item, but then you can actually get the item because people are going to sell this stuff to you. And then when you open the chest, you know, let's say like this is a shop right here, you have a little sell sign right there, you can sell iron, you know, ingots for, let's say, like 57k. People are like, wow, that's so much better than the mine I currently have, and then they start selling. Then when you go on the server, you can actually click it, get all the little iron, go to like your mine, right, that was worth a little bit more, and bam, you can make a little bit of profit, as you can see, because it's 60k, but you were selling it for 57k. So it's a win-win on that situation as well. So I recommend you guys do that, OP shops and stuff like that, try to make it insane. And also for admins and stuff like that, if you guys will have that, make sure it's legit, you know, don't spawn stuff and all this other stuff, because that's gonna mess up. That's kind of obvious. Just letting you guys and the staff know. You know what I mean? But yeah, that's something that you guys can do, and it's a win-win for, you know, both situations. Something else that you guys can also do is actually warps. That's a different command that I recommend you guys remember as well. Simply because this will tell you some things. You know, you can go to this mine, you can go to this animal farm, so on and so forth. Remember that so you can actually go to your appropriate location. So if you wanted to get some food or something like that, let's go to Animal Farm 1. And there you go. There's a lot of piggies right here. Wow. But pretty much you go in here and you know, get some food or whatever you're trying to do on there. Maybe you're trying to get some XP for MCMMO or something like that. So you could do that. And just remember that command as well. There's a lot of commands, guys. I'm trying to remember this by just memory, which I probably should have written this stuff down. Let's see what else there is. For the OP prison, when you are ready to rank up, as you can see on the right hand corner, it says bank account, it says money required. You should know how this stuff works. If you played a different you know, prison or OP prison before, a different server, pretty much you get the money required, and then after you have enough, you can rank up if you want by just doing /rank up. Then you'll be a different rank. So instead of me having, for example, the A next to my name, if I ranked up, I would have the letter B, and then if I ranked up, I would have the letter C, so on and so forth. It goes all the way to Z. We do not have any prestiges yet. Maybe, you know, in the future, you know, if we get, you know, bungee cord and stuff like that, just a lot of improvements, we might add some prestiges and stuff like that to extend the gameplay a little bit more. So yeah, be aware of that, guys. That's how you rank up, but that's That's very simple to do if you haven't played on a prison server or open prison. Some other things I recommend you guys probably remember as well is there's so many. There's seriously like a lot of things. I can give you guys some tips as well on how to make a little bit of money as well. You can make money in here just by animal farms or by PvPing, simply because you actually get a little bit of money every single time you actually do something like that. So let me get like a sword or something. Probably gonna get the one, there's one over here. Let me get this one. And as you can see, it gives me a little bit of money. Bank account, bam, it shows how much I have right there. So that's really, really cool. So you can actually make money by PvPing and stuff like that. And also, like in PvP, for example, you can actually, it's a possibility, it's not guaranteed, but it's a possibility when you beat somebody in PvP on like a duel or, well, not, we don't have duel yet, you know, like a 1v1 arena, we don't even have that yet, but it's kind of like a, it's a free-for-all arena. But if you go in there and you beat somebody, there is a way you can actually get player heads, like the actual, like, something like this, like that. It'll show like the skin of the Minecraft skin of the person you got, and you can sell this stuff and you can place it down. People use it as trophies, like, yeah, look who I have right here, look at that, I have, you know, so on and so forth, blah blah blah, person this, that, which is, you know, you can do that. You can sell this stuff in your plot meat shop, or just, you know, you can do that, you can sell it if you want, you know. It's like a little trophy people like to collect that time and time, because it's like you have to beat somebody to actually get that, and it's not guaranteed. Some other things you can also do for commands if you want to sell something is actually use auctions. Auctions pretty much makes it so you can actually put something into a market and it will try to sell it. So let's say if I want to sell this thing, auction, and then we'll tell you a bunch of commands that you can do. Just go here and do auction start. There is a certain limit, so you can't go too low, you can't go too high, the way I set it up. I forgot what the numbers were, but if you start messing around with this, with the numbers and all that stuff, it should work for you eventually. So right here, you put auction, start, and then amount. So if I want to sell one of these, the price, let's go with like 1820 with 10 at the end. Increasement, I wanted to increase, so if someone puts like bid, if they want to actually up the price, it would just increase by like 10,000, and then you can put like auto win or whatever, you know, you don't really have to. Oh yeah, I can't be in creative as well, have to be on game mode 0. If you do that, as you can see right there, it tells you auctions, Vasterz, auction 1, human face, and you can highlight over this and it will tell you a little bit more information. I believe the way it's set up is if you sell an actual PvP player face, if you highlight over it, it tells you the person's name. So make sure you actually check that out, because maybe someone's going to be like selling blah 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 head trophy, and you know, maybe they say a certain name or something like that, and then you highlight over it and it's just a regular, you know, maybe it was their own like head trophy item and they just want to get a little bit more out of it. It's messed up, that's a scam, that's not cool. But as you can see right there, someone ended up like bidding on this or just paying it off completely, they'll be able to actually get the item, which is very, very, very cool. So yeah, as you can see right there, auction is going on. Wait 10 seconds. If no one actually ends up buying the item, it will actually return it back to your inventory. Like as you can see right there, it's back in my inventory. If your inventory is full, it will actually drop the item in, you know, on the ground, so it'll pretty much look like that. So that's something you guys can do as well. There's just a lot of ways, guys, that we have for you to actually make in-game monies, for you to actually continue to rank up on, you know, this game mode. We have a lot of stuff on there, you know, a lot of ways to, you know, sell stuff, to trade stuff, and, you know, it's like a market, I guess you would say. You know, you can actually, you know, sell stuff to other players or buy stuff from other players and stuff like that. Something that I do recommend you guys know as well is one that more likely you guys will have to go to, more than likely, simply because the regular kids aren't that great, the ones to start out with. But you do, what I just did, it's Warp Shop, and right here is a nice little shop area, and you can go over here if you want, and you know, pretty much it says armor, supplies, blah blah blah. And right here's the armor, so if you wanted to buy some armor, this only gives you the armor. So let's say if you lose it in PvP, it's done. It does not give you a command or nothing like that for right now, just letting you guys know. So right now, let's say if I paid for this one, which is 1 trillion, it says right there, which is the dub kit, which is very, very OP. But let's say if I were to buy that and go to PvP, so if I go to Warp PvP 1, which is Arena 1, let me do that. So if I go to this right here, let's say if I go down here and I'm PvPing somebody with the, you know, the kit, whatever I got, I end up losing, the person ends up picking up my stuff, that's it. You know, you can't, unless if the person gives the item back to you or something like that, because you pretty much lost it. You know, it's, you have to be very, very, very careful when you enter PvP, because if you lose, you'll lose the armor, pretty much. So you have to be very, very careful, because if you lose the armor, you're going to have to pay for it again. So it's very, very difficult. I know that a lot of other servers, prison servers, they actually break Mojang's rule on, you know, donation stores. They end up setting they end up making the server pay to win. So if you pay, you get, you know, like a rank, you know, that gives you like an infinite amount of kits or something. That breaks the fun of the game. That pretty much is pay to win. It's not fair for people that, you know, can't, you know, maybe they don't have a PayPal, maybe they don't have a credit card or something like that. It's not really fair for them, because they're gonna keep getting owned and stuff like that. It's gonna be a lot more difficult for them. But on our server, it's all equal right there. All the items that we sell on our donation shop are pretty much cosmetic and or will be global stuff. So for right now, that's not set up, but maybe in the future, we will add something like double XP for the whole server, you know, for a certain amount of time if someone donates. I don't know. But on our server, it's pretty much cosmetics. It's not pay to win. So yeah, our donation store is very, you know, it's pretty much like other servers, like I think Mineplex, Hypixel, CubeCraft, they have that sort of thing. They have, you know, cosmetic items that they sell, whether it be particles, pets, things like that. That's what they have, and that's what we have as well. It's not easy, I know, for people to buy stuff like that, but, you know, it's up to you guys. You know, you're helping the server if you end up buying a rank and stuff like that. So you're helping with the paying the bills and stuff like that, because it's very, very expensive. And I'm glitching real bad right here. I'm not sure why. I'm gonna have to figure this out. Let me know if you guys know what it is. It's usually when I'm right here in this little zone for the PvP. It kind of bugs out a lot. I'm not really sure why it does that. More than likely, I will increase the server plan, but that kind of makes absolutely no sense. Like, on why this do this? Why do this? You know, like if I'm like in the kit PvP, it's fine. But if I'm on this one, it glitches real, real bad. I don't know. I gotta do some testing on this, see why it's doing that. Okay, that gets kind of annoying. I'm not sure what that could be. Yeah, that's pretty weird. But yeah, I think that's about it, guys. I kind of just covered some things. And, you know, I was talking about donations. If you want to support the server, you can go to our website as well, which is called thelightiness.com. And remember that the server is... the main one that I recommend you guys use to go into the server is play.thelightiness.com, you know, with the, you know, what's it called, like the minus sign thing. So yeah, with do that, and then you can go on the server or the website, or you can simply just do /buy and you'll take it to the GUI menu of the actual shop from the website. So if you want to buy a rank, or if you want to buy a pet, or you want to buy a trail, something like that, you just click it and it will tell you, like right here we have a little selection. You can pick trails or event trails. Event trails are actually for like right here, you can barely even see it because it's, the text is so long, but it pretty much is like events, like, you know, Christmas or this or that. We have trails for that specifically that you shouldn't be able to buy until they're released. So right now it's a little sneak peek on that stuff. Right here is our regular pets. If you want to buy some, like say if you want to buy let's say if you want to buy a pig pet, it will cost you $7 in real life money. USD is what it is, the way I set it up. Hopefully I set that up correctly. But it tells you the price of stuff. You know, you can also go for ranks, you can go for upgrades. So if you're a faithful rank, you want to click on here, it will show you the, like, the upgrades and stuff like that you can actually put for your rank. So it goes like this: faithful, fisherman, and rainbow rank, and there it shows you the price. It's really, really cool. So that's an easy way to actually do that. Once you click on that, it will take you to a link. Once you click on the link, it will take it to, you know, show you like details of the item and all this other stuff. So yeah, we'll just take it to, it redirected to the website, and it's really, really cool to have, you know. So yeah, I think that's about it, guys. I kind of shared a lot of important details and stuff like that, that I recommend you guys to remember the stuff, to be aware of it, so you guys are more ready to go. There's other commands, but these are the really, really, really important ones that I recommend you guys remember. You know, I'm pretty sure I probably forgot maybe, you know, a couple of them or something like that, because there's so many commands, guys, that we have. But those commands are very, very important, and I just want to share that with you guys, and also let you guys know about the domain thing. You know, it's play.delightinus.com to get to the server. It's the one that works the best for right now, it seems like, so that's the one we're sticking with for the server. As for the website, it's the same thing, delightinus.com. So yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know about that. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any plugins or anything you want us to change or add to the server, because this is our first server. I know a lot of people probably will be like, change some designs. I mean, look at this. This is a lot better than the hub lobby area. The hub lobby area, it requires some work. And more than likely, if we start getting, you know, some donations and all this other stuff, I'll, you know, put some more money into the server, you know, and slowly start expanding it so we can go to Bungie Core, because I really want Bungie Core, guys. You know, God willing, because it's so nice. It's insane. Compared to Multiverse, yeah, that's Bungie Core, homie. So, yeah, guys, there's just a lot of plans that we have up ahead for updates and all this other stuff. Game modes to add, and just a lot of things. So, even some things on, like, let's say we, like, before the Bungie Core or all this other stuff. Some other things we could add is more arenas. So instead of just having one, just a PvP1, we might add a different one, like PvP2, PvP3, stuff like that. Just a little small updates like that we can do on the server. We can't, like, for right now, we can't really add an insane amount like of game modes and all this stuff, simply because our server runs on Multiverse and it's one core for the Minecraft, and the server might lag a lot if there's too many people, because it's running, like, if someone's in the lobby and someone's in the OP prison, it's the same server, you know. Unlike Bungie Core, it's a different server, so it works a lot better. So we can't really add too much of different game modes or this or that. More than likely, what we could do is simply redesign stuff, you know, change a couple maps, or, you know, add some things to it, you know, add a little bit of a section, more PvP, more mines, I don't even know. Building designs, something like that. We can do that, but we can't do, like, something else, you know. I was thinking also about doing something like that, that we could do is make a different world, and, you know, the staff can come on that world, you know, hang out, and we will actually probably will be working, like, this is an example, but I was thinking about if we do this, it can make a world that allows you to use pets and trails, and that world is like a roleplay world. Obviously, don't be inappropriate, you know, follow the guidelines, the rules that we have on the server, but if you want to make a video and, like, you know, I know there's people out there, what is this? I know there's people that do, like, these little role plays, like, how you doing? Who are you? Oh, Mr. Block. And they do something like that, and some other people enjoy it, you know, they're YouTubers. I sometimes see that, it's kind of entertaining sometimes. Sometimes it's just flat out weird, you know, depending on the episode that they're talking about or whatever it is. But I might do that. If the staff is watching this, let me know if I should add something like that, you know, a different world, which the staff can just go in there, expand the world. Maybe I was thinking of making like a city or a castle sort of thing, like an actual open massive map, and people can just walk over there and just hang out. And, you know, it's not a game mode, it's just something that you just hang out on and just chill, you know. And if you want to make a video of a role play on the server, you can do that. You know, I was thinking about doing that, guys. So staff members of Enlightenus, let me know if we should do that. Obviously, even to you guys, let me know if you should add that. Let me know if you guys would be interested in that, because a lot of servers, they actually don't have that. They don't have that little section for the little hanging out, or, you know, just, you know, something like that. They don't really have that other than like the lobby area, but that's not like a role play, or, you know, like a little, it's pretty much like a, it's like a movie. You're making a movie sort of thing on the Minecraft server sort of thing. Let me know if we should add that, guys. I was thinking about doing that. So yeah, let me know, guys. It's just little things that we could add, like building and stuff like that. We could add that. Things like game modes, we can't add that yet because it's gonna mess up the server. in the lag and all this other stuff is gonna make it run like a lot worse. Unless we get bungee cord, then we can just go all out. There's a bunch of demos that I've been talking about. I want to add Skywars, I want to add survival games, I want to add, you know, a bunch of stuff. And more than likely on our website, I'll be running polls, you know, little votings that you guys can go to the website and say, like, which game mode should we add next? And then I'll give you guys a selection or something like that. More than likely, I'll do that so you guys will get an insight and you guys can pick the next game mode. Because I know a lot of you guys want factions, but I know other section of you guys, you know, some want factions, but some want, like, Skyblock. And some want this, some want that. And I might make, like, a little poll thing saying, which game mode do you want? And, you know, maybe it gets, let's say, like, Skywars gets voted up more than Hunger Games or, you know, survival games. Then Skywars gets added, and then again, which game mode do you want next? So on and so forth. But that's way ahead of time. That's bungee cord status. But you guys will be getting an insight. You guys will be selecting stuff. So you guys will be kind of, you know, like, all I'm basically doing and staff are doing is just adding stuff. We want to make sure that you actually enjoy the server and stuff like that and have a nice, safe, and fun experience on the server. You know, for, you know, all ages, you know, there's a lot of rules that we have, you know, that, you know, language or this or that, you know, because there might be, you know, you got to remember, you know, there's little ones and all this stuff and, you know, they shouldn't be exposed to that sort of messed up things, even though I know we're in a fallen world, but come on. And something like this on a game, you know, we have some rules, and, you know, you can be 10 years old or you can be 50 years old. You know, you're welcome on the server, and, you know, we can hang out, I guess, and stuff. So, yeah, that's something that's pretty cool on our server. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much about it, guys. Letting you guys know a little bit of information in the future. God willing, also things about right now, how's it going, basic commands that I recommend you guys check out and use. I know this video is pretty long as well, but I think I covered what I wanted to cover there. I'm thinking, like, if there's a command I'm missing or something like that, but I don't think there is. There might be, but I can't really think of any right now. And also, if you guys do slash help, it actually will just give you this. It'll tell you rules, and you can do that. It'll tell you the rules. So if you do slash help, it'll tell you rules. It'll tell you the tell message if you want to private message somebody. Slash help if you want to go back to the lobby. And slash leave is for, you know, the future if you're into, like, a little mini game or something like that. If we add one like TNT or something like that, TNT run, you'll do slash leave more than likely to leave the actual game mode. You know, if we ever add game modes like that to some of them in the future. So yeah, that's pretty much what it is, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully, you know, you guys will enjoy the server. But yeah, I really gotta get started to fixing this issue, because it happens all over here. I'm not really sure what it is. So yeah, I'm not really sure. Very, very, very strange. But hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. My name is Vasterz, aka G Saves, and I'm signing out. May Jesus Christ be with you guys, and God bless you guys. Make sure the description down below has a lot of good stuff down there. But I'll see you guys when I see you guys. So yeah, may Jesus be with you. God bless you guys.
Break it down to a second, a million thought, a dream. The limit with the power of believe. Just soak it up like a flower, like a summer field, aching to be healed. Just rain on me. You.